The sparkling city by the bay is the site for a Southland Conference showdown. Jason Hooten, Sam Houston State Bearcats are coming off a three-point win at Lamar and need a victory to move into fourth place ahead of their opponent tonight, Texas A&M Corpus Christi. The Islanders head coach Willis Wilson wants to snap a two-game skid after his team started 9-0 in league play. Hang around. The Southland Conference Game of the Week is next. Welcome to Corpus Christi, Texas. We're here at the American Bank Center. 7-2 Islanders of Texas A&M Corpus Christi versus the 7-3 Bearcats of Sam Houston State. It's a great matchup from here in the Coastal Bend. I'm Jeff Power here at Courtside. This matchup is one we've been looking forward to all year long. In fact, in the eight previous meetings, there's only been one victory by the Islanders, and it happened right here last year. Can they do it again? We'll find out. Let's tune in now and check out both Neil Raphael and Tom Franklin, who have tonight's call. Guys?
All right, Jeff, thanks very much. Good evening, everybody. We welcome you to the American Bank Center, where the Texas A&M Corpus Christi Islanders, 7-2 on the year, but trying to snap a two-game losing streak, will take on the Sam Houston State Bearcats, 7-3 in conference play. And when we get to February, Neil, we get close to this time of the season where each game is so important. And the way the Southland Conference tournament is shaping up, you want to finish in one of the top four places so you can get at least one bye in the conference tournament.
Exactly. It's crunch time. With only 1 month left in the conference season, every game counts, Tom.
Been a rebuilding year of sorts for Jason Hooten and the Sam Houston State Bearcats, losing four senior starters from last year's team, and Paul Baxter V getting hurt before the season started. So that has meant the junior forward, Aramis Myauskas, has stepped up into a leading role.
Yeah, Myauskas, the 6'8 junior forward from Lithuania, is averaging 14 points on the season, almost six rebounds, and right now is eighth in the Southland Conference in field goal percentage at 54%.
For the Islanders, they are led, of course, by their outstanding post player, Rashawn Thomas, a five-time Southland Conference Player of the Week. But he needs to have company. Somebody else has to come along for the ride and be the co-pilot, and maybe tonight is the night that Brandon Pye gets back on track.
Yeah, Brandon Pye, the 6-foot senior guard out of Mansfield, is averaging 14 points on the season, Tom. He's third all-time for the Islanders in three-point makes, but right now he struggled on Tuesday night against Incarnate Word. Like I said, 14 points on the season, but only 3 points on Tuesday night, so he really needs to get on track tonight.
He made the first basket of the ball game for the Islanders and wasn't heard from again. Willis Wilson and the Islanders need to have him back in gear in tonight's ball game. Stay tuned. We'll have the starting lineups and the opening tip-off for tonight's game from the American Bank Center in Corpus Christi right after this timeout here on Root Sports Southwest. And you're back here at the American Bank Center in Corpus Christi, Texas. Texas A&M Corpus Christi playing host to Sam Houston State. And for the Bearcats, they'll line up this way tonight with Dakari Henderson, Javonte Spivey, Aramis Myauskas, who we talked about in the open, Jamal Williams, who has had to step into the starting point guard role, and Albert Almanza, who is making his sixth straight start after starting the year as a reserve. For the Corpus Christi Islanders, Hamid Ali, Brandon Pye, who we featured in our open, Jelani Curry, Bryce Duvier, and Rashawn Thomas, the five-time Southland Conference Player of the Week. A guy who brings it night in and night out, Neil, but, you know, Batman had to have Robin. Sundance, you know, the Sundance kid had to, you know, Butch Cassidy had to have the Sundance kid, so Rashawn Thomas can only do so much. He's got to have that second guy to help him out somewhere.
Yeah, and the Islanders shoot pretty well at home, so they need a great start offensively tonight. We know they'll have their natural lockdown defense, but offensively need to get on track early.
Other action today around the Southland Conference, just underway about midway through the first half. Stephen F. Austin out to the early 17-8 lead over HBU. HBU, the surprise team of the Southland Conference, starting 8-0 until losing on Tuesday night. And now they're on the short end early on in a home game against the first place Stephen F. Austin Lumberjacks. This afternoon, Incarnate Word held off Lamar 74-71. Nichols State with a 71-56 win over McNeese State. Southeastern Louisiana all over Abilene Christian by a score of 81-60. And Central Arkansas, boy, did they light it up against New Orleans, 112-77. So the standings coming into today is action. You see Stephen F. Austin at 8-0, the lone unbeaten team. Houston Baptist with one loss. The Islanders here of Corpus Christi in the third spot right now with Incarnate Word tucked on their heels a half game back. And Sam Houston State just one game back at 7-5. So they're both a half game back, rather. One in the win column, one in the loss column. Those are the five teams. And right now they're trying to separate themselves a little bit. Positions 3 and 4 get one bye in the tournament. Positions 1 and 2 get two byes in the tournament, Neil.
Yeah, so there's a big difference in second and third, and there's a bigger difference between fourth and fifth getting
Absolutely.
That first round bye.
So that's how it stands up. Very competitive league this time around in the Southland Conference. One of those mid-majors that you're going to start hearing about making noise in the NCAA tournaments from here on. So far, Stephen F. Austin, the only one that's been able to advance to the NCAA tournament the last couple of years. Both Texas A&M Corpus Christi and Sam Houston State last year going to the College Insider Tournament last year, and they would like to take the next step and be at least the second team maybe from the Southland to make the big dance.
Yeah, these two teams played three times last year. Sam Houston State taking two of the three meetings, and the more important one was in the semifinals in the Southland Conference Tournament, Tom.
Each team won at home. Sam Houston State winning the first meeting up in Huntsville. A&M Corpus Christi winning down here in the American Bank Center. And then in the tournament, as you mentioned, in the semifinals, it was Sam Houston State going on to post the victory. So you see Jamal Williams, the jump center, against Rashawn Thomas. The homestanding Islanders in the white uniforms, and for Sam Houston State, they have the visiting blue trimmed in orange and white. Kind of unusual, Neil, to see Sam Houston State in blue and not the orange.
Yeah, exactly.
Jelani Curry from the left wing, no good. Bryce Duvier fought for the rebound and does get the offensive board. So reset the 30-second clock for the Islanders. Nice kick out on the outside. Curry again trying to get by against Henderson. Can't. They find Duvier off the right block now. Duvier in with the right hand and a nice little right hand flip from Bryce Duvier.
Yeah, good to see Duvier get off to a great start. Only 6 points on Tuesday after averaging 10 on the season.
First possession of the ball game for the Bearcats. This is Javonte Spivey. He'll take the three out top, no good. Reaching in for the rebound, had it knocked out of his hands, was Jamal Williams. Williams, an interesting story, 6'4", 190. Out of Episcopal High School, a sophomore, was thought to be a wing player. And with the injuries at the start of the season to Paul Baxter, and then as the season went on to Amir Jackson, he's developed into the point guard. And there you see Myauskas with the first basket for the Bearcats.
Yeah, big sky hook from Myauskas, stepping away from the basket and nailing that one.
Two apiece. Thomas, ball taken away down on the low post, and away comes Williams. On the wing for Dakari Henderson, a very streaky three-point shooter from the outside.
And last time these two teams met last year was a two-point contest. The Islanders coming out on the better end of things.
Williams had his pocket pick. Curry lobs it up and too tall for Rashawn Thomas. You know, one of those plays, Neil, that coaches cringe over all the time. you have an opportunity for a basket, the players go for the highlight film and it backfires on them.
Exactly. Fundamentals, fundamentals, and more fundamentals.
So still even at two.
If it goes down, it's all good, right, Tom?
Absolutely.
It's one of those no, no, yes, right?
Always good until somebody gets hurt. 10 to shoot for the Bearcats. Off on the wing, Spivey, and he lost it out of bounds. 6 to shoot for the Bearcats. Both of these teams known for tenacious man-to-man defense, and you're seeing it early on. Poked away from behind by Hamid Ali.
Both these teams average over 70 points, but it seems every time these two teams meet, Tom, the game's in the 50s.
Trying to drive the baseline was Albert Almanza, and he stepped on the sideline. Before he made his move, that little back step got the heel on the sideline, and the turnover will go the way of the Islanders. Two minutes, 15 seconds gone by, just underway in our Southland Conference Game of the Week from the American Bank Center in Corpus Christi. Duvier, fadeaway from 8, got the back iron, no good. And Williams will take the rebound away for the Bearcats. Open on the wing, Henderson for 3.
Wow.
Dakari Henderson, the junior out of Pearland Dawson High School.
What a quick trigger for Henderson.
You don't want to see him make his first couple because he's one of those guys, once he makes one, it turns into 5 or 6.
Yeah, Duvier trying to get the ball down the low block.
Left
it
short.
They're pushing him out defensively. Nice job by the Cats defensively.
Almanza cleared the board. In the lane, Myauskas had it poked away, got it back. Got Duvier up in the air. We get a foul right there before the shot as they got the pump fake on Duvier and got him up off his feet.
And we'll see the transition opportunity.
The fake.
It's really kind of a lost art, Tom, the head and ball and shoulder fake. You just don't see it that often, but it's very effective.
Henderson with back-to-back three-pointers, that one from the left-hand corner. And it's off to an 8-2 lead for the Bearcats. You got to pin down that guy. Do not let him get free. Thomas passes out of the low block. Curry steps in for the 18-footer, missed it. Rebounding foul, and it's going to be Myauskas, I believe. A little shove in the back of Rashawn Thomas. Right away up off the bench for head coach Willis Wilson, Joe Kilgore, and Ehab Amin.
Yeah, it's on the back side, the push in the back.
Curry and Ali will step out. New 30 for the Islanders, and a steal on the lazy pass. Going to the basket is Spivey, couldn't get it to go, and Pye guilty of the foul. I'm not going to credit that turnover to Pye. I'm going to credit that one to Thomas on the soft pass. And right away, checking in the ball game is going to be Dale Francis. So head coach Willis Wilson not happy with the way his starters are going, and he's not afraid to go to his bench.
Nice job of Spivey offensively in that transition opportunity, Tom, of leaning into the defender and forcing the foul.
Spivey, a 70% free throw shooter, misses the first of two. Duvier out and Francis in.
Spivey, one of the 4 JUCO transfers for Sam Houston, 4th leading scorer on the team.
Missed them both. And Thomas snatches the rebound away from Albert Almanza. Two, the Bearcats with the early lead thanks to 2 3-pointers from Dakari Henderson in the early going. Thomas double-teamed on the block. Skip pass out for Brandon Pye. Now to Dale Francis. Shot clock is down to 5. Kilgore will take the 3. Joe Kilgore. Are we going to foul here on the shot? Basket is good. Foul is going to be on Rashawn Thomas for a push. On rebounding, let's watch it here.
Also on the Islanders, number 25, Rashawn Thomas.
You saw Thomas go over behind the defender and take him to the deck. Cuts the deficit down to 3, 4 minutes gone by. Loose ball, chased down. Brandon Pye recovers. Ehab Amin to the basket with the left hand. Young sophomore out of Alexandria, Egypt. Noted for providing energy off the bench. You saw it there. Majauskas way out top, guarded by Francis. Lees for Williams in the lane. Up and under move, rolled off, no good. Pye clears the rebound. Amin will push for the Islanders. Behind the back he goes. Off on the wing, Francis, a deep three.
Wow.
Dale Francis.
My goodness. The big man for three, did on both ends, Tom. He started the transition down here with a steal, got the ball up and nailed the three.
32% three-point shooter, you would never know it from that shot. Foul on the floor committed by Ehab Amin. And we've got a good one going. Action end-to-end, 10-8. Texas A&M Corpus Christi with a two-point advantage over the Bearcats from Sam Houston State. Texas A&M Corpus Christi with the lead over Sam Houston State. Bearcats are 3 of 5, 2 of 3 from long range. The Islanders 4 of 8, also 2 of 3 from long range, Neil.
Yeah, the game started out with the Sam Houston Bearcats up 8 to 2. The Islanders now on an 8-0 run, Tom.
Bearcats with the ball, checking in Josh Delaney. Off in the corner, Almanza's shot partially blocked by Thomas. And away come the Islanders. It's Amin. Pulls up from the free throw line. Banked it in. I heard him call bank.
Especially in the American Bank Center.
That's right. You're going to get that.
Both teams shooting exceptionally well, Tom, here in the first half.
Now it's a 10-0 run now for the Islanders. Almanza, no good. Rebound taken down by Amin. And boy, has he lit a spark in this Islander team since he came off the bench. Here's Pye for three, way short. Rescued underneath by Thomas. He'll put it out to Francis for three. Not this time. Rebound Majauskas, and we're getting a foul on Amin.
Yeah, a little too aggressive by Amin.
The bad part of that is that's a second foul on Amin.
Yeah, sometimes you just have to tone it down. There you go.
Came up and under and got him. Backing Majauskas to the bench, so that'll bring Hamid Ali back into the ball game.
Coach is saying, hey, it's not worth a chance on one steal. Yeah, we steal the ball a lot. We're very good with that, and we're leading the conference. But
almost 10 steals a game.
The exchange is not worth it. One foul for one possible steal.
And your second foul puts you on the bench.
Exactly.
Again, heavy pressure. Pass thrown away underneath. And the pressure defense by the Islanders. Getting to the Bearcats, that trip down the floor. You got to look at Joe Kilgore, number three for the Islanders going by us. The way he was shuffling down the floor, he looked like he was 75. But this kid can jump out of the gym.
Yes, he can.
Conserving his energy. Kilgore's got the ball. Feeds inside for Thomas. turnaround 10-footer for Rashawn Thomas. His first bucket of the night. And it's now a 12-0 run for the Islanders.
Wow, Thomas is able to face up and nail it. 12-foot jumper for Rashawn Thomas.
Williams feeds inside. This is Andre Sands. Ball taken away by Francis.
Number one rule of big men, don't put the ball on the floor.
Here's Ali, steps in, 18-footer, rolled off, no good. Rebound, Thomas got shoved out of the way, and the rebound taken off by Sands. Up the floor they go, they find Torrey Butler in the lane. Tough shot off the glass for Torrey Butler.
Torrey Butler.
Yeah, I think both teams are going to go very deep in their benches tonight. They both go 8 or 9 deep, maybe even 10 with the energy here, Tom.
Butler, one of those junior college transfers you talked about, started for them about the first 16 games of the season. And then Jason Newton said he lost his confidence a little bit and has seemingly settled in as a role player off the bench now. Baseline jumper, high arcer, no good by Pye. Thomas with a putback with the left hand.
Nice wrap around that time by Thomas on the offensive board. And he looks focused.
Up off the bench, Emmanuel Toney for the Islanders. Duvier going to come back in, as will Majauskas. Bearcats feed inside. Sands through a double team. Locked by Thomas. Loose ball on the floor. Who's going to get it? Still loose on the floor. Picked up by the Bearcats and put in by Sands. Wow, what a play.
My goodness, those 50-50 balls. The energy on this floor right now is amazing.
6'8", 245 from Freeport in the Bahamas. Andre Sands, number 23. You see that muscular build. He got the loose ball from the pileup. Ali with a drive and going to get a body foul on the outside.
Yeah, that's on Butler.
Bring us to an official's timeout. 11:43 to play here. First half at the American Bank Center. Southland Conference action. The Islanders of Texas A&M Corpus Christi owns a 4-point lead over the Bearcats of Sam Houston State.
Probably ought me to look at the annuity program too.
I'm a CPA. I love helping people. I'm Patricia Quintana Pro, and I'm a tax partner with BKD San Antonio. Life at Texas A&M Corpus Christi was busy. I was very focused. I was a working student. I went back to Texas A&M Corpus Christi to obtain my master's because it provided value and because I really love the atmosphere at the university. I love the way the teachers were involved in our careers and in our futures. When it comes to business management and accounting, Texas A&M Corpus Christi has what you need.
My family has been growing crops here since the late 1800s.
We're Texas farmers through and through, and that's why we love HEB. They've been supporting local farms like ours for generations.
And they buy more of our corn than anyone else in Texas.
Over 10 million pounds annually, and they use it to make great products like HEB corn chips.
So when you try them, you're eating a little piece of Texas.
We're the Sawdoff family, and this is the locally grown department at HEB. No store does more than my HEB.
Down to Katy, March 9th through the 13th at the Merrill Center. Go to Ticketmaster.com or Southland School Ticket Offices.
Minutes, 43 seconds to play first half. The homestanding Islanders of Texas A&M Corpus Christi with a 4-point lead at 16-12. Both teams shooting well still, 50% for the Bearcats on 5 of 10. The Islanders are 7 of 16. The difference, Neil, in this ballgame, 5 turnovers for Sam Houston State, which have been converted to 4 points. 3 turnovers for the Islanders, no points for the Bearcats. Whoa, swatted away from behind. Nice move as Kilgore was going up for the shot, and it was Jalen Barnes who came in and knocked it away.
The Islanders currently on a 14-4 run, Tom.
Inbounds for Francis, back to Ali. Toney to Kilgore in the corner. Kilgore had his pocket picked. Stolen away by Butler. Check that, Williams. And Williams goes coast to coast.
Did a nice job of wrapping it around on the other side, protecting and scoring at the rim.
Just in case there was a trailer coming. Use that iron. Right now, the Islanders content to play on the perimeter. Swing it in the corner, Emmanuel Toney. Back iron, no good. Duvier gets the long rebound. New 30-second shot clock for the Islanders. Hamid Ali, senior point guard. Spiritual leader of this team. Fires from three, no good. Rebound, Duvier couldn't get it that time. Good positioning by Butler to hold the inside. Jamal Williams, pass almost lost, picked up by Butler. Swing it near side for Henderson. Majauskas. Majauskas down low with the right hand jump hook for two.
Yeah, big size advantage there by Majauskas.
On the switch, got the smaller man, just went right up over the top with the jump hook and ties the game at 16-all as we approach midway here in the first half. Ball slapped away that time by Barnes. They leave it for Williams. Faked the dunk and went with a left-hand lay-in. Jamal Williams, back-to-back baskets for the Bearcats.
Yeah, Sam Houston doing a nice job in transition.
Willis Wilson did not like the last couple of trips down the floor. He's going to call a 30-second timeout here with 9:54 to play in the opening half. And the Bearcats back on top by a score of 18-16. See the huddle for Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Last couple of times down the floor, turned the ball over. Got their pockets picked, led to transition baskets. Guys not getting back on defense. You see head coach Willis Wilson getting into his team. I need focus for 40 minutes. You cannot relax against this team.
No, you can't. It seems like every time they've had a transition opportunity, Tom, they've taken advantage.
Halftime now, Stephen F. Austin, Houston Baptist coming back, making a two-point game at the intermission. Everything else final played earlier this afternoon. We'll keep an eye on that one as the Lumberjacks, the lone unbeaten team in the Southland Conference right now.
And what a great crowd, Tom, tonight for basketball here in Corpus Christi.
Well, it's homecoming, and not only the students come out, but the alums are here, and they're making it sound loud here in the American Bank Center. Undoubtedly their best crowd of the year. Duvier out between the circles. Tried the entry pass, yeah. Couldn't get it to Thomas.
That's a tough angle. You've got to go with a guard. You got to swing it to the wing and enter it from the wing, not from the top.
Straight on and not at a 45-degree angle. Jelani Curry comes back in the ball game for the Islanders. Bearcats on a little run here. Six in a row. Here's Majauskas. Leaves for Williams. Tried to dish it off. Nice touch pass. Got it to Butler. Couldn't get it to go. Butler again. Couldn't get it to go. And Duvier finally muscles his way in to clear the glass for the Islanders. Quick entry for Thomas. Fouled on the shot.
And Tom, that's what this game's been so far. Sam Houston started out the game with an 8-2 run, 8-0 run for the Islanders, and then a 6-0 run for the Bearcats. And we'll see the foul there. Thomas doing a nice job on the low block of forcing the contact and getting to the free throw line for two.
Spivey came by from the backside, got him right in the small of the back. He saw his back bow. Rashawn Thomas, good free throw shooter, 71%, misses the first. Pull the Islanders to within one and does. Five now for Rashawn Thomas.
Islanders have really improved free throw shooting, 75% Tom on the season, only 68 last year.
Nice stop and pop jumper for the free throw line by Barnes. Couldn't get it to go and the Islanders will clear again. Under nine to go in the first half, 1-point game. Islanders with a chance to go back on top with a bucket here. Pick and roll for Thomas. The 15-footer is no good. Rebound skying high and taking it down was Torrey Butler. Jonte Spivey leaves it outside for Butler and now Majauskas between the circles. Almost a travel there. Majauskas, good entry pass down low. The defense forces him outside. Back in for Majauskas. In the lane for the shovel, blocked by Thomas. Back to Majauskas, swinging outside, steal. Emmanuel Toney going to the basket, right-hander is good. And one, Emmanuel Toney streaking down in transition.
My goodness, coast to coast. Look at that. Look at the hustle on the 50-50 ball and the layup on the other end.
Great job of protecting as they went by.
What energy.
And they weren't going to call a foul. They were going to call goaltending, but the ball went through anyway. So no free throw coming up. 19-18. Islanders back on top. Biaskis checks out as Almanza comes back in. Spivey out between the circles, harassed by Ali. Off on the wing now for Barnes. Looked inside, couldn't get it. Oh, it's a steal. Loose on the floor is Curry. Ball picked up by Dubier and threw it away.
Yeah, just kind of threw the pass and then turned his head.
Trying to settle things down will be Josh Delaney for the Bearcats. Delaney leaves for Barnes. If you're a coach, you got to like the way these teams get up after the opposition defensively. A lot of harassing. Shot clock down to two, down to one. Just before the buzzer, no good by Delaney. Rebound taken out by Thomas.
Both these teams like to extend the defense beyond the arc.
Down low for Dubier. Muscles it up with the right hand for two. Bryce Dubier.
And much needed basket for Dubier.
3-point lead again for the Islanders with 7 minutes to go now in the first half. Driving on the outside. Spivey travel. Dubier with a good defense brings us to an official's timeout. 6 minutes, 53 seconds to play. First half, it's been back and forth. Each team has had the lead a few times. Right now, the Islanders own it by 3 over the Bearcats. Texas A&M Corpus Christi on top of Sam Houston State. Our Southland Conference game of the week. Some of the fans here, and you see the student section behind the basket to our left as you watch here. You see how they're packed in on this homecoming night. Interesting little stat here in the early going, Neil. You mentioned early on that Sam Houston State getting a lot of contribution off the bench, 22 points. Right now, it's the Corpus Christi bench with a 12-4 advantage. Got those productions from Kilgore and Amin, Tony, and Francis.
And that's what Corpus Christi wasn't able to do on Tuesday. Weren't able to get contributions from anybody really other than Rashawn Thomas.
Oh, Rashawn Thomas airmailed everything with a 10-footer from the right side of the lane. Ball will go over to Sam Houston State. Jamal Williams, 9 points, 5 rebounds, and 4.5 assists per ball game since taking over the point guard spot. Aramis Majauskas. Henderson looking for his third three. That one was short. Rebound taken down below by Williams. Ball poked away, loose on the floor. Finally coming away is Ali. Too long for Thomas. Got one paw on it, but not enough to control it.
Too long and a little too hard.
Baseline.
Whoa,
drive. Henderson.
My goodness.
Oh, ho. He says, I'm not just a three-point shooter. Watch this.
Wow. Thunder on the baseline for Sam Houston. My goodness.
8 points now for Dakari Henderson to lead all scores. 5:50 to go here in a very entertaining first half at the American Bank Center in Corpus Christi. Ali out high. Off the block as Thomas trying to go baseline. Offensive foul. Yes, indeed. Second foul against Rashawn Thomas.
Yeah, we'll see Myauskas here. Does a nice job of moving his feet, extending his arms, and taking the hit. Great position by Myauskas.
People have to remember, a defensive player does not have to be steady at all times if he's in front of the defender.
Correct. He was in great position there.
Great positional defense by Aramis Myauskas. Here's Williams with a drive, swatted away by Francis. He's not known as a shot blocker, but he got it there. Ali for Pai, 17-footer is short.
Yeah, Pai was fading to his left on that delivery. Needs to get his feet under him, make sure everything is lined up.
They need to make a little bit better decisions in transition like that. That wasn't a bad shot, but it wasn't a great shot. He didn't have his feet under him, as you mentioned. You can get that shot anytime. Three from the corner by Henderson is no good. Back comes Texas A&M Corpus Christi with 5 minutes to go. Islanders on a one-point lead. Here's Duvier driving. This time the defender did not get there in time. Almanza will pick up the whistle.
Yeah, a little late on the offside help. There we'll see it.
See, he's on the side.
Exactly.
Didn't get in front. So Francis will leave for Pai. Back to Francis. Three for the left corner. No good. Chasing down the rebound. Jelani Curry couldn't control it. Henderson's got it. And now to Williams. So the Bearcats will get in their half-court offense. Myauskas in the lane. For Henderson, going down the baseline, and he got fouled going up. Bryce Duvier picks up the whistle. It'll be his second, so the big man for A&M Corpus Christi in a little trouble here with 4:37 left in the half.
Yeah, you'll see the great pass by Myauskas at 6'8". When you're double-teamed, Tom, able to look over the defense and kick it out.
That line for the Bearcats, number three, Dakari Henderson.
So Dakari Henderson at the free throw line left the first one short. He was chasing it the minute he let it go. He knew it was short. 72% from the stripe on the season.
Needs to stay up on those toes, Tom. Total extension.
Kilgore gets ready to come back in for the Islanders. In and out, no good. 0 for 2 for Henderson. So the Islanders keep their one-point lead. Coach Willis Wilson directing the play to Hamid Ali from the sideline. High off a screen, back to Ali, calls another one with 10 to go now on the shot clock. Ali against Almanza, he'll take the three, no good. Rebound, Myauskas tipped it away to Henderson. The Bearcats come back the other way. Williams for Henderson. Dropped it back on the outside for Almanza, now Williams again. Henderson, left corner three, in and out, no good. Rebound, Williams muscled up, left it short. Francis will clear this time for the Islanders. Outlet pass to Ali. Baseline for Duvier, watch out from behind. Shoveled it off for Curry. Left-hander, short. Rebound by Myauskas.
Yeah. Guarded that time by three players. Even though you're closer to the basket, he was defended hard.
Timeout, Bearcats.
Now the Bearcats will call a timeout and we'll make an official timeout with 3:25 left here in the first half. We've been back and forth, and right now the Islanders from Texas A&M Corpus Christi own a one-point advantage at 21-20. A look at downtown Corpus Christi, Texas from Selena Quintanilla. The monument there to the great Hispanic singer who died way too early. 21-20, Islanders with a one-point advantage over the Bearcats here in your Southland Conference Game of the Week for the American Bank Center in Corpus Christi. Bearcats have the ball in front court. Jalen Barnes will inbound. 20 to shoot for the Bearcats. Biasca setting the high screen. They double-team Williams out of it. Switch it to Almanza. And now in the corner for Spivey. Left his three ball short. Rebound underneath. Cleared out of there by Jelani Curry. Both teams have gone cold here from the field between cold shooting and turnovers. We've been stuck on this 21-20 for a while. Kilgore around Francis' screen, dishes back on the pick and roll. Francis for three, halfway down, won't go. Rebound taken out by Williams.
Yeah, Francis nailed his first one, but struggled a little bit from beyond the arc.
Now one for three. Outside for Almanza. Back on the wing for Barnes. Now Spivey. Spivey in the corner. Three, in and out, no good by Barnes. Rebound taken down by Kilgore. Saw the leaping ability right there as he just knifed his way between people. Down to 2:10 left here in the half. Step back jumper by Curry is no good. Rebound taken out by Barnes. He'll bring it up the floor himself. Leave now for Williams. Under 2 minutes to play until halftime. Here's Almanza for Majauskas, and poked out of there by Hamid Ali. Substitution, it'll be Viktor Juracek who will check in.
As you mentioned, Tom, both teams have struggled with turnovers, so right now they're trying to work the shot clock. They're looking for quality shots in the half-court set, trying to slow down the pace.
13 to shoot for the Bearcats. Behind the back pass, they swing it in the corner. Almanza's three is no good. Rebound tipped in the air. Hamid Ali will take it down for the Islanders. Minute and a half to go until halftime. Kilgore trying to attack the lane, put it up with the right hand. Whistle. And one for Joe Kilgore. What a tough drive to the hoop. Count the basket. And the foul is on Jamal Williams.
Watch. Yeah. There we go. Nice penetration amongst the multitude. There were four bodies there. Nice finish by Kilgore. At the line for your
Islanders, number three. Williams had his position. The trouble was his heels were on that restricted area line. So that makes it an automatic blocking foul. Kilgore completes a three-point play for the Islanders.
Well, and Kilgore started this game hot with a three-pointer beyond the arc. Gone a little cold, now finished with another three-pointer. So that's 6 points for Kilgore here in the first half. Much needed ammunition off the bench for the Islanders.
Here's Williams trying to attack the lane. Drops it outside for Spivey. And around on the wing for Henderson. Dakari Henderson. Now with 10 in the ball game.
1 minute remains.
He's one of those guys to go way back in basketball parlance. He's a Vinnie Johnson type player. He's the microwave. When he starts heating up, look out. Shot from the free throw line, no good. Juracek couldn't get the rebound. And the Bearcats come back with a chance to tie or go in front. Majauskas couldn't control. Taken away by Tony. Tony leaves it on the wing. Kilgore will lay it in.
Kilgore. Nice transition by the Islanders. 2-on-1 break and the finish at the rim. Just great precision pinpoint passing there, Tom.
Just tenths of a second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Williams out high. Tried to pass it inside, kicked away by Kilgore. 8 to shoot for the Bearcats. 9 seconds left. Now Now they've turned the shot clock off. The shot clock might have to go back. Nope, they reset with a kick ball. So it'll be 9 seconds, so they will get the last shot. They lob it back for Williams. Williams trying to attack Kilgore. On the wing, in the corner, Almanza's three is good. Albert Almanza makes it a one-point game as the buzzer sounds to end the first half. Almanza picks a great time to get his first basket of the ball game as he hits from three. Jeff Power going to go try and run after head coach Willis Willison and get a word with him as we go into the locker room with his Islanders on top by one. And Jeff, go ahead and take it away.
Joined now by Willis Wilson. First of all, your thoughts about the first half?
Well, it wasn't the prettiest half, I don't think, by either team. We had a stretch where neither team could score. We both want to do the same things. We want to dictate the tempo of the game with defense. We want to attack the rim on offense. Both teams are doing a pretty good job of really limiting that penetration.
And your team leads the league in steals, and they're showing that again tonight defensively.
Well, we're going to have to manufacture some offense off our defense this half to stretch this lead.
Okay, Willis Wilson, back to you guys in just a moment. Tom?
All right, Jeff, thanks very much. Back and forth we've been in the first half here, and the Islanders own a one-point lead at 26-25 over Sam Houston State. Stay tuned. Our halftime activities coming your way next after this timeout from the American Bank Center.
I'm Christy Felice, and I am the Director of Brand Engagement for the Houston Astros. Texas A&M University at Corpus Christi has absolutely helped get me to where I am today, and it is a small campus with large opportunities. You should definitely choose Texas A&M University, Corpus Christi.
Named a top Texas university for return on investment. Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Discover your island. Visit us for Island Day at islandday.tamucc.edu.
At Navy Army, we're proud of our military roots, but you don't have to be in the military to be proud of where you bank. If you live in South Texas, chances are you can join. Each year, we welcome thousands of new members looking for a better way of banking. So carry that card with confidence, because we take your financial success seriously at Navy Army Community Credit Union. Does your bank do that?
I'm not originally from South Texas, but what do they say? I got here as fast as I could. I'm Steve. This is home, this is work, this is my church family, and cancer wasn't going to take me away from any of this. I received the right cancer care right here at home. Texas has been my home for 25 years and counting. I'm still counting because of the doctors, nurses, and great people of Christus Spahn. Thanks, Christus Spahn, for keeping me close to the things that matter most.
On behalf of all student athletes, thank you to the members of the Islander Athletic Fund for allowing us to earn a great education at the Island University.
Thank you for giving us the opportunity to play the sports that we love.
Thank you for preparing us to achieve excellence in the classroom, in competition, and in our community.
Thank you for providing us with a first-class campus experience.
Thank you for the chance to represent Corpus Christi with pride.
Thank you for making us Islanders for life.
Thank you for making us Islanders for life.
Thank you for making us Islanders for life.
Halftime here at the American Bank Center in Corpus Christi, Texas, where the Texas A&M Corpus Christi Islanders own a 26-25 lead over the Sam Houston State Bearcats. Tom Franklin, Neil Raphael back with you here courtside at the American Bank Center. And Neil, quite an entertaining first half. Both teams having a little run, then a dry spell for both teams as we approach the halftime buzzer, and maybe halftime coming at a good time for both coaches.
Yeah, it's been a high-energy game so far, Tom. Like you mentioned, an 8-2 run for Sam Houston to start the game, and then Corpus Christi comes back with their own 8-0 run.
26-25 is our score. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half, and we had quite a few high-action and high-energy highlights to talk about in the ball game. Aramis Majauskas, the leading scorer for the Bearcats, with a jump hook in the lane. Then an outside three ball, two in a row from Dakari Henderson, helped spark them to that 8-2 advantage. But then off the bench, Ihab Amin leading the break down the floor, this time kicking out for a three ball from Dale Francis. He provided instant energy, hits his own basket, a little bank from the free throw line, but then picked up two fouls and had to go to the bench. Here's Rashawn Thomas, leading scorer for the Islanders. And a nice drive by Torrey Butler between players to get it up. Brandon Pye, baseline jumper no good, but Thomas was there to clean up. Steal from Jamal Williams. A nice reverse layup with the left hand. Williams again through the defense in transition. Speaking of transition, how about Emmanuel Toney? Now Williams back down the floor, and Henderson, look out below.
Yeah, a little exclamation point.
Nice bounce pass for Kilgore. And we finish up here with a three ball for the corner right at the buzzer by Albert Almanza that make it 26-25, pulling the Bearcats to within one. Been an entertaining first half. We'll delve deeply into these statistics a little bit later on here in our halftime activities. But Jeff Power coming by with some special guests and some special information as we continue with our Southland Conference Game of the Week from the American Bank Center in Corpus Christi, Texas.
And welcome back to the American Bank Center here in Corpus Christi. 26-25, the Islanders of Texas A&M Corpus Christi leading Sam Houston State. Great first half here. One of the top players is Rashawn Thomas for the Islanders. He's won the Southland Conference Player of the Week award five times this year, averages 17 points a game and 8 rebounds per contest. He's the go-to guy for the Islanders. In fact, he lost a lot of weight since last season. Here's his story.
Killer Brew. Spent a lot of time studying and watching film, things like that. But after all that, you know, I really just stayed in the gym and had a vision, really, of who I wanted to be when the season came around. And then when I looked up, I was that person.
First impression of Rashawn, watching him coming out of high school, was that he was a guy that had a motor. Even in drill work, he just had a lot of fortitude and a lot of intensity. And as a coach, when you see a guy with his size working as hard as he did, and discovering that was a regular daily occurrence, you just feel like guys like that have a chance to play early on in their career when you combine tenacity and body type and drive. And that was probably the second thing that we discovered about Rashawn, is that he's just so driven, very, very, very competitive. As a junior, at midpoint of the season, the most notable things about Rashawn that are different. Obviously his body, he's really trimmed his body down and gotten himself into a sleek mode where physically he can do more things and last longer. He can outquick guys at his position. And that kind of really leads into the second thing that allows him to outplay bigger people is just his skill level, his improvement of shooting the ball, his mid-range shot has really, really improved dramatically. He's been able to combine a mid-range shot with attacking people off the dribble, and he's discovered a nice balance in those things. Still needs to improve on his long-range shot, but he's shown improvement there, and I just think that's one of those things that over the course of the season, we'll begin to see that a little bit more.
When I started liking it, I got real competitive. You know, everybody loves it when you start winning, you know. So as I got better, I started winning more. I started getting more hungry for success and things like that. And then as time went on, I kept getting better and better. I paid a lot more attention to some detail with my game, aspects of the game, how defenses are guarding me, things like that. I feel like my basketball IQ has just shot up really since my freshman year. You know, being under Coach Wilson and some of the veteran players that are here now, I've learned a lot. And so I think that's what's helped me so far this year as to being a better player and my production going up. You know, I wanted the team to be first place where we are now. And just to win a championship, man, I feel like I have like a vision is just to create a mid-major dynasty alongside Coach Wilson and the program and everything that we started since the beginning of this. So for us to just be where we are now is really a blessing.
I don't think there's any question about Rashawn. There are very few days where he dials it down, and on those days it's usually recommended. He's one of those guys that needs to really take care of his body and make sure that he's physically healthy and able for the long haul of the season. But that being said, he is a guy that's going to give you his best effort. He just knows one way to go, and that's to go hard. You know, you talk about confidence and security blankets. We have a lot of guys that can shoot the ball from the outside, but as this season goes on, their ability to shoot the ball is really going to be contingent on us being able to establish an inside game. And when you can establish an inside game with a guy like Rashawn, an inside game is not just throwing the ball inside, but it's having that post presence and having the ball in his hands consistently. Rashawn, over the course of his career, has always been a very, very good passer. He plays very unselfish, and that's certainly reflected in his numbers and his willingness to do a lot of the yeoman-type work. But when it's all said and done, just having the confidence to throw it in there, and as a shooter, knowing and expecting that the ball is going to come back where you can shoot shots in rhythm, not have to hunt shots, is really significant for basketball.
When I first started playing the game, I really started playing just to get a scholarship, to be honest. You know, I was the worst player on my high school team my freshman year. And then as playing and getting better and trying to get better, I just ended up falling in love with the game.
It's constantly changing.
Hello.
It's not a desk job. I'm on my feet all day.
This is Trevor 3 East.
I'm Trevor Bonzer, and I'm a nurse manager at Chris's Spawn Shoreline. The faculty at A&M Corpus Christi, you see the passion in their teaching. They will challenge you, and they will motivate you. They want you to succeed.
Named a top Texas university for return on investment, Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Discover your island. Visit us for Island Day at islandday.tamucc.edu.
Down to Katy, March 9th through the 13th at the Merrill Center. Go to Ticketmaster.com or Southland School Ticket Offices.
Texas A&M Corpus Christi men's basketball is back at the American Bank Center this Monday night in a key matchup at the top of the Southland Conference standings. Your hometown Islanders tip off against Houston Baptist at 8 p.m. The first 750 fans through the doors will take home a limited edition Izzy the Islander bobblehead. Beat the crowds and secure your seats today by calling 825-BALL or visiting the American Bank Center box office.
My family has been growing crops here since the late 1800s.
We're Texas farmers through and through, and that's why we love HEB. They've been supporting local farms like ours for generations.
And they buy more of our corn than anyone else in Texas.
Over 10 million pounds annually, and they use it to make great products like HEB corn chips.
So when you try them, you're eating a little piece of Texas.
We're the Sawdoff family, and this is the locally grown department at HEB. No store does more than my HEB.
26-25, the Islanders leading the Bearcats here in Corpus Christi. Joining me now is Scott Lazenby, the athletic director here at Texas A&M Corpus Christi. And first of all, homecoming festivities going on here, and great to see all the ceremonies going on before and during the game.
Yeah, we had our women's game earlier today at 2 o'clock, and they knocked off Sam Houston by 10. Then everybody went outside in the beautiful weather for the tailgate, the parade, and now they've all come in tonight. So big crowd tonight. It's a great day.
And I want to pass along that Jonathan Lee is the king and Anna Wisenhunt is the queen for homecoming. So good for them. But let's talk a little about the tennis team that was also honored earlier today. I mean, winning conference titles for them seems to be like no big deal.
Yeah, our Islanders men's tennis team led by Steve Moore has been a great addition to our program here. I think it's 9 straight conference titles by them. And Steve Moore just reached his 300th career win as a coach. Just a great program. They're very, very well liked in the city, a city that really loves tennis, and they back us great in that sport.
And on top of that, they really love baseball down here, and your baseball team has had a lot of success as well.
They do. This is a big baseball time with the Corpus Christi Hooks. The high schools around here are big, but our baseball team is always pretty good too. We're always up there fighting for the conference title. We haven't gotten there yet. We're real close, and I really think Scott Malone's got a really good program this year. Some good hitters, a lot of good pitchers. So we're excited. That's 2 weeks away.
And not afraid to hit the road, play teams like the University of Texas and other top-notch programs across the state.
Yeah, we go to play up at Texas in April. We also play up at A&M this year in April. We usually play Rice, University of Houston. We're not scared of anyone. It's baseball. You play anyone, anybody can win.
Tell me about beach volleyball coming on campus. That sounds like a good time.
It's a new NCAA sport. We started it this year, so it starts in March. It's about a 6 to 8 week season. We're on the beach. Why would we not have it? So it's a great compliment to our indoor team that just won the Southland Conference. We're excited to start it. We think it'll be a really good sport for us.
On top of that, you just hired a coach too.
Yes, his name is Steve Green. We pulled him away from A&M up at College Station. He's one of their assistants. Excited to have him here. He's originally from California, so he's got a beach volleyball background. So we're excited to get him here and get our program running.
Very good. Scott Lazenby, he's your athletic director here at Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Let's take a quick timeout. The Islanders are leading 26-25 over the Bearcats of Sam Houston State. We'll be right back in just a moment.
26-25, Texas A&M Corpus Christi on top of Sam Houston State as we get set for the second half here at the American Bank Center. Look at the first half statistics. And Neil, you see it's very close. And remember how both these teams started out shooting the ball really hot, around 50%. Look how it winds up, 11 of 29 for Sam Houston, 11 of 31 for Texas A&M Corpus Christi. The numbers even almost throughout. One number that doesn't show up there that is a difference, 2 out of 3 for the free throw line for the Islanders, 0 for 4 for the Bearcats in the first half.
And that surprises me because the aggressive nature of this game so far, not a lot of fouls have been called. And at this point, we'll see what happens in the second half, if they're going to have to create offense and get to the free throw line. One other thing that sticks out, A&M Corpus Christi, 17 points off the bench. Sam Houston State only 4.
Let's take a look at some of the other action around the Southland Conference today. Only one game still going on. They're late in the second half in Houston, where the Houston Baptist Huskies trail the unbeaten Stephen F. Austin Lumberjacks 61-56 with about 5 minutes to play in that one. Incarnate Word, Nicholls State, Southeast Louisiana, and Central Arkansas all posting wins earlier today in the Southland Conference. So coming into today's action, these teams separated by a half game. The Islanders from Corpus Christi 7-2 in Southland play. The Bearcats from Sam Houston State 7-3 coming into today's action. So as we start the second half, ball will belong to Sam Houston State. In the road, blue uniforms trimmed in white and orange. Texas A&M Corpus Christi and the home whites trimmed in blue and green. So here we go.
It seems like anytime these two teams meet, we have a dogfight.
Absolutely.
Separated by very few points.
Majauskas tied up on the low block. Duvier comes in to tie up the ball, and that'll send it back to Texas A&M Corpus Christi.
Yeah, see a heads-up play there by Duvier. Keeps his arms extended, just reaches over his shoulder of Majauskas and ties it up and gets the alternate possession.
He was so worried about the short man coming in front, swiping it away, that he forgot about the big man behind him. Here's Amit Ali. Swing it in the corner for Brandon Pye, a guy we featured at the start. 0 for 3 in the first half, and a good strong move to the basket by Rashawn Thomas to start the second half for the Islanders.
Yeah, Pye really hasn't touched the ball a whole lot, only 3 times.
Running jump hook with the right hand, no good by Almanza. Duvier clears away for A&M Corpus Christi. Man-to-man defense for both teams. You're not going to see zone from either one of these teams. Here's Thomas on the baseline. 15-footer rolls out, no good. Duvier with the putback, left hand. No, tipped it again. Got it the third time. Duvier strong around the hoop with 6. The lead has been built out to 5 by Corpus Christi.
You know, Duvier doesn't have a lot of points, but he's done a lot of the intangibles tonight. Fought hard on the offensive glass. Done a lot of things to help the team.
Bad pass by Spivey, picked off by Curry.
You saw Duvier down defensively just a minute ago, tied it up.
Duvier for 3. Nope. Couldn't get it to go, and Majauskas will clear and wait for people to get out of the way before giving it to Jamal Williams. Williams with a couple of end-to-end runs in the first half to account for his 4 points. Majauskas, quick move, lost it, got it back, put it up, no good. Rebound, Majauskas fights for it, ripped away by Curry. Out to Ali, and now on the wing for Pye. His 3, no, it's offline, no good. Rebound taken by Spivey. Ahead he comes. Henderson will stop and pop inside the arc from 18. And a timeout called by Jason Hooten. And the Sam Houston State Bearcats, so we'll take it with them. 17:52 to go in our ball game. Still a hotly contested battle between the Islanders and the Bearcats, and Texas A&M Corpus Christi currently owns a 3-point lead.
I'm from South Texas, but what do they say? I got here as fast as I could. I'm Steve. This is home. This is work. This is my church family, and cancer wasn't going to take me away from any of this. I received the right cancer care right here at home. Texas has been my home for 25 years and counting. I'm still counting because of the doctors, nurses, and great people of Christus Spahn. Thanks, Christus Spahn, for keeping me close to the things that matter most.
At Navy Army, we're proud of our military roots. But you don't have to be in the military to be proud of where you bank. If you live in South Texas, chances are you can join. Each year, we welcome thousands of new members looking for a better way of banking. So carry that card with confidence, because we take your financial success seriously at Navy Army Community Credit Union. Does your bank do that?
I'm in Midland, Texas, in order to be closer to the action and see actually what is going on with our drill bits.
I'm Valerie, and I'm a field-based designer for Baker Hughes. There's not that many females in the mechanical engineering industry, but it's growing. A&M Corpus Christi prepared me for my career. The professors are able to talk to you one-on-one. Based off the class sizes, you're able to get more hands-on experience. If you're interested in engineering, A&M Corpus Christi should be your first choice.
Named a top Texas university for return on investment. Visit us today at tamucc.edu.
Good crowd on hand for homecoming night in Corpus Christi, Texas at the American Bank Center. And the hometown Islanders with a three-point lead over the Bearcats of Sam Houston State, 17-52 to play in our ball game. Texas A&M Corpus Christi with the ball to get things started. Hamid Ali. Off on the wing, Jelani Curry. Tried to pass it back out for Thomas, and it was stripped away by Jamal Williams. Bounce pass on the wing, Henderson. Had it poked away from behind by Ali. It'll stay with the Bearcats with 26 to shoot.
Yeah, I truly believe Ali saved a basket there, Tom. Yeah. He had the angle, had the lane.
Williams looking to inbound. He better get it in a hurry. Just got it in for Almanza and poked away from behind, but a foul on the reach around on Hamid Ali. Coach Willis Wilson wanted to say, you know, he only gets five inbounds there on the baseline. They thought it took a lot longer than that. Williams quick inbound for Almanza. Shot no good. Rebound and a foul on the floor. Is it going to be Myauskas?
Or
it is. Myauskas over the back. He was the guy who wound up on the deck, but watch here. Duvier is inside. Yeah. You see Myauskas come over the top.
He did. Both fight real hard for that rebound. Been battling all night. Duvier, Myauskas.
Yeah, this is not a battle for the weak of heart.
And for the most part, the refs have been letting them play.
As long as it's consistent at both ends, neither coach gets upset. Entry pass for Duvier, slapped away. A long down court for Myauskas. Can't control it, goes out of bounds, and back to Texas A&M Corpus Christi.
Yeah, that's a tough pass to catch over the shoulder like that.
Number 13, Marcus Myauskas.
Marc-Andre Fortin comes in the ball game. Freshman, true freshman, out of Quebec City, Canada.
There we'll see that lead pass, and the 6'8 Rashawn Thomas was there. Makes it even more difficult.
3 minutes gone by here in the second half. Three-point lead for the Islanders with the ball. Duvier going baseline.
Whoa!
For the slam around Almanza. That'll get your attention.
Duvier's really stepped it up tonight.
Three ball is no good by Spivey, but a second chance for the Bearcats. Couldn't control it on the baseline and goes out of bounds.
Yeah, Duvier with only 6 points. We'll see the exclamation point, the baseline drive. Slams it down. Duvier with only 6 points Tuesday night, but has really stepped it up tonight on both ends of the floor.
He did have 10 rebounds in that ball game,
correct,
but only 6 points offensively. And thus far in tonight's ball game, Duvier with 8 points, and he also has 8 rebounds.
Yeah. Good chance he could get a double-double, Tom.
3.5 gone by now in the second half. Islanders with a 5-point advantage. Brandon Pye, entry pass, saved by Thomas. No, couldn't save it. Stepped out of bounds. Unforced error by the Islanders.
And that's an underrated stat. That's something that's not easy to get, a double-double.
Turnovers now, that's the 7th of the ball game for A&M Corpus Christi, 11 for Sam Houston. Kari Henderson, who's been the offensive show for the Bearcats. He's got 12. Only player in double figures for either team. And at Spivey with a body foul on the sideline by Duvier. Will bring us to a timeout. 15:52 to go. Sam Houston State has taken a one-point lead at the break and built it out to five here at the American Bank Center in Corpus Christi. Fifteen-52 to play, five-point lead for Texas A&M Corpus Christi. But a guy who has been instrumental in the Islanders getting to this point, Bryce Duvier, 8 points, eight rebounds, just picked up his third foul as we went to break, Neil.
Yeah, see if that's a factor down the road here. And early here in the second half, four turnovers for Sam Houston. The Islanders have converted 4 points on those four turnovers.
Jamal Williams leaves for Henderson, going baseline, swatted out of there. Curry and Thomas both going for the block and got it away. 23 to shoot still. Let's take a look again here. See Curry from behind and Thomas from the front. Inbounds out toward the midcourt stripe for Spivey. Spivey can't get by Hamid Ali. He'll leave it for Williams. Shot clock down to 12. Back in Spivey's hands. Now for Torrey Butler. Majauskas hounded by Thomas. Back out for Williams, down to two. He has to launch a desperation three. It's no good. Jelani Curry pulls down the rebound. Great defensive set that time for the Islanders.
Yep. 30 seconds of hard-nosed defense from the Islanders.
Hamid Ali, Ihab Amin is back in the ball game now, and he was the inspiration off the bench early on. We get a foul down low. And it's coming on Marc-Andre Fortin.
Bearcats number 33, Mark Fortin, his first personal foul, second team foul.
He's got a tough task, young freshman out of Quebec trying to hold down Rashawn Thomas.
Only freshman on the squad.
From the right elbow, Thomas's jumper is no good. Jamal Williams will clear it down. Williams trying to play pick and roll with Majauskas, couldn't find him. Leaves it for Spivey instead. Spivey around Curry. Left it way short, ball loose in the lane, and the loose ball taken away by Brandon Pye. Now to Ihab Amin. Amin through the lane, back outside for Pye. Still looking for his first points. Thomas double teamed on the block. Finds Amin, 3-pointer left of center. Oh, he missed everything. Rebound to Jamal Williams. Devontae Spivey. Williams on the baseline, back out to 14. Ball knocked out of his hands and recovered by Ihab Hamid Ali. As many times I've seen these guys play, I always get them confused. Every time. This is Ali on the drive, up with the left hand, blocked by Majauskas. Loose ball, recovered by Thomas. Loose still in the lane. It's Amin, couldn't get it to go. And Williams will finally take the rebound down for the Bearcats. couple of great opportunities for the Islanders, couldn't cash in. Dakari Henderson leans in, couldn't get it to go. Thomas takes down the rebound.
It's in your defense, Tom, it's easy to get these guys confused. They both have the same skill set.
One's got a headband, one doesn't. I think I'd pick up on that.
I'm trying to help, Tom.
I know. Here's Thomas down low. Kicks it back outside for Pye. Now for Amin's three. Got it this time. Ehab Amin with seven now off the bench. And it's 35-27, 8-point lead, biggest of the night for the Islanders, yeah, with 13 minutes to go.
9-2 run to open up the second half for Corpus Christi.
Here's Butler in the lane, leans in, no offensive foul, Torrey Butler.
Yeah, he was outside. We'll see. He's outside the restricted area here. Great job by Thomas. A full extension taking the brunt of that hit. It's going the other way.
Butler picks up his second foul. Sean Thomas will sit down, as will Jelani Curry. Dale Francis is back in the ballgame for the Islanders, along with Joe Kilgore. Kilgore with a big first half with 8 points off the bench. Very instrumental in the Islanders having that 1 point lead. Ali from the right elbow, back iron no good. Long rebound, Myauskas will track it down. Ball poked out of the hands and they say a last touch by Williams. It was Ali coming around from behind and started it out of his hands and forcing the turnover.
Check in for the Bearcats, number 15.
Now Josh Delaney will come in. Jamal Williams will have a seat for the Bearcats. So the Islanders now have a chance to break this thing open a little bit. 8 point lead, they could be the first to get a double digit advantage in this ball game. Approaching 12 to go, here's Pye for the right elbow! Brandon Pye finally breaks the drought and gets on the board with his first basket and makes it a 10 point lead, 37-27.
Yeah, again, the Cats have had a lot of trouble the first 8 minutes, Tom, only one basket.
Here's Delaney, scoops it with the left hand, won't go, rebound cleared out by Kilgore. Kilgore will weave his way down the floor, find Amin. Amin trying to go baseline, we get a foul on the floor against Jalen Barnes and bring us to an official's timeout. The Islanders have come out strong with an 11-2 run to start the second half. And have opened up a 10-point lead on Sam Houston State.
I hear you. Caesar or Roland? All right, Caesar. That's fine.
Rules are simple. Just make a single shot.
Yes.
Let's make some noise. All right.
All right, that's fine.
Hey, give me a shot at number 20. 20 in blue. Sam Houston, number 20.
37-27, Islanders leading the Bearcats here in Corpus Christi. By the way, forward Jamal Williams, he's 6'4". He's a point guard. Well, he started the season as a forward. He actually does the tip-offs here. No other point guard in America can say that. Of course, it all started with some injuries. Paul Baxter, he's missing because of a foot injury earlier in the year. Of course, he's the son of Ron Baxter. And quite a few other injuries for Sam Houston State. Somehow they've overcome this year. All right, let's get back to more action. Tom?
All right, Jeff, thanks very much. 37-27. And since making five of their first 10 shots in the ball game, Sam Houston State has gone ice cold. Seven of their last 29, including one for 10 here in the second half, Neil.
Yeah, including seven second half turnovers, Tom.
17 turnovers in the ball game. That surpasses their average of only 12 per game.
Only three for the Islanders here in the second half.
Points off turnovers. A&M Corpus Christi with a 14-6 advantage in that category. Final score in from Houston, and Stephen F. Austin remains unbeaten with a 72-66 win over Houston Baptist. The Huskies losing their second straight now in Southland Conference play. So here are the Islanders with the ball. Ihab Amin, top of the circle for Brandon Pye. Step back 18-footer, won't go. Rebound on the backside, taken off by the Bearcats. That is Jalen Barnes. Delaney from the deep left wing. Josh Delaney gets on the board for the first time and breaks a long drought for the Bearcats and brings them back to within seven. That's what happens when you get that backside rebound. Oftentimes you can give up transition points because everybody else is on the other side of the floor. There's Victor Juracek in the ball game at the top of the key. He leaves for Kilgore. Kilgore stumbles, keeps the dribble alive, however. He'll shoot a three, partially blocked, trying to go for the foul and crashing hard was Amin, no foul. And away comes the Bearcats. Bajauskas back on the outside for Delaney. Leaves now for Barnes. Inside for Bajauskas, trying to drive on Juracek. Back outside, jumper from the wing is no good by Spivey. Francis will clear and give it to Amin. He dribbled it off of Francis, but keeps it alive. Bearcats are having trouble making a basket here in the second half. Only two. Here's Kilgore around Juracek's screen. Finds Juracek. He'll take the three left corner. No good. Goes in after his own rebound. Picks it back outside. And a new shot clock for the Islanders as Brandon Pyle settle. Pyle shoot the three. A rainbow left it short. Amin tipped it. But when he tipped it, he was out of bounds. So it'll go over to Sam Houston State.
Yeah, Pye still trying to find his rhythm. Has been off balance the last couple of chances.
Saw it right there, and you saw Amin come underneath with the deflection. But he was out of bounds with the left foot. He tried to go on the flyby. Just past the midway mark of the second half. The Islanders from Texas A&M Corpus Christi with a 7-point lead. On the wing is Albert Almanza. Pounded by Thomas, and Thomas is going to get the whistle. And for Rashawn Thomas, that'll be his third.
That's going to be his third. And we see coming in Dubier with his third personal coming back on the floor.
Got the feeling they may kind of alternate.
Swap.
You keep one of those guys on the bench at all times. Nope, they're going to get Dale Francis. Leave both guys with three fouls.
Wow.
On the floor. So Willis Wilson with a 7-point lead. Going to roll the dice here a bit. Bearcats go back to work offensively. This is Josh Delaney. Leaves for Almanza, back out top now for Henderson. Henderson to Delaney. Bajauskas throws it out. They swing it in the corner. Three is on the way and good to Kari Henderson. Even though he had to pull it up from his calf, his left calf pull it up in the middle, he still got it away. He's got 15.
Yeah, good ball movement, good patience that time for Sam Houston. They cut the lead now to four.
Kari Henderson with 15 in the ball game, including three three-pointers. Ihab Amin drives, left it on the bottom of the backboard, knocked out of bounds. Last touch, they say, by Sam Houston State. They'll have 11 to shoot. An inbound from the left of their offensive goal.
Tom, 6-0 run for Sam Houston.
Come back to within four. The inbounds for Thomas. Now Amin. Shot clock is at 6. Amin with the left hand. Shovel couldn't get the roll. Dubier tried to tip it to Thomas, but it was too strong. Away come the Bearcats. Delaney to the basket. High off the glass for two more.
Yeah, it looked like he was going to spot up Delaney for the three-pointer, and then he accelerates to the rim for an easy lay-in.
37-35. 8-0 run now for the Bearcats. Thomas trying to drive baseline. Got tripped up. Foul's going to be on Myauskas. It'll be his third.
Fouls on the Bearcats number 13.
Five team fouls now against Sam Houston State. Three against Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Jelani Curry and Hamid Ali come back in. On the inbounds pass, baseline jumper is good by Hamid Ali, and he had a contact knocked loose, I think. He's trying to get the officials' attention, but they're not stopping the clock for him. Here's Butler on the drive, swatted away, but a foul.
By committee, will that be on Dubier?
Dubier,
so,
yes.
It's his fourth personal foul. Wow.
How about the shot by Ali? He took a shot in the face for his trouble. Now just getting a chance to put his contact back in. 8:06 to go here in the game. 4-point lead for the Islanders. You see Ali still trying to get that contact lens settled.
And you mentioned the risk by having two young men in there with three personal fouls.
And here comes Dale Francis. You know, they're still checking with Ali to see if he's got it right, and he doesn't have it right yet. Going to be two shots for Butler. He may have lost it now.
Wow.
Yeah, all that fiddling around trying to get it settled. Well, he's got it back. And it's probably on his finger. He's going to bring him over to the bench.
Probably
here.
Has a little dirt in it as well.
Yeah,
but I need to
be
clean
nice
that
to
up.
Rinse that thing off a little bit. Yep. Training staff is out there with the saline bottle. We'll wash it off. Much easier to put a moist contact in if you've ever worn contact lenses before than a dry one. Dry ones aren't easy. And I think Hamid Ali's going to be okay now. And now Dale Francis will check in for Bryce Dubier. So Dubier with that 8-8 first half, still at 8-8. He's got zero on the score sheet here in this, or he was 8-8 earlier in the second half. He's got 4 points in each half. Let me correct that. Free throw is no good by Butler.
Yeah, Butler, one of four junior college transfers. Leads the team in rebounding at 6 per contest.
How about this? Sam Houston State is 0-for-6 from the line. They've had three guys miss two times from the line.
Exactly.
They make those free throws. They got the lead in this game.
Yeah, 0-for-4 in the first half with Sam Houston.
Here's Thomas, tough five-footer, no good. Rebound underneath Delaney, fights and takes it away. They go in the corner for Butler. Trying to go baseline, passes out to Myauskas, got it out of trouble. Myauskas against the short of Curry, ball deflected by Ali, but right in the arms of Butler. His drive, no good. Offensive foul called on Torrey Butler as Jelani Curry took the charge with 7:32 to go. Islanders, one time led by 10 here in the second half. The Bearcats have come back to cut it to within 4. Don't you go away.
Down to Katy, March 9th through the 13th at the Murrow Center. Go to Ticketmaster.com or Southland School Ticket Offices.
Texas A&M Corpus Christi men's basketball is back at the American Bank Center this Monday night in a key matchup at the top of the Southland Conference standings. Your hometown Islanders tip off against Houston Baptist at 8 p.m. The first 750 fans through the doors will take home a limited edition Izzy the Islander bobblehead. Beat the crowds and secure your seats today by calling 825-BALL or visiting the American Bank Center box office.
Probably ought me to look at the annuity program too.
I'm a CPA. I love helping people. I'm Patricia Quintana Pro, and I'm a tax partner with BKD San Antonio. Life at Texas A&M Corpus Christi was busy. I was very focused. I was a working student. I went back to Texas A&M Corpus Christi to obtain my master's because it provided value and because I really love the atmosphere at the university. I love the way the teachers were involved in our careers and in our futures. When it comes to business management and accounting, Texas A&M Corpus Christi has what you need.
Back here at the American Bank Center in Corpus Christi, where the A&M Corpus Christi Islanders own a 39-35 lead over Sam Houston State, 7:32 to go. Both teams having a hard time putting the ball in the hole in the second half. Combined, the two teams are 10 of 36.
Wow. Sam Houston, 0 for 6 from the free throw line after shooting 69% from the line on the season.
Rebounds in the ball game even at 33 apiece. Turnovers 18 for Sam Houston State, just 12 for A&M Corpus Christi. And here is Hamid Ali for Jelani Curry. 15 to shoot for the Islanders. Ali trying to drive around Williams, kicks it out for Pye's three, bullseye!
Wow.
Brandon Pye with a big three-pointer from the right-hand corner. Extends the lead out to 7.
And his first basket of the evening fires the crowd up. It's all a confidence thing when you're a shooter. You have to have a short memory, Tom.
Shooters have got to keep on shooting, too. Here's Delaney for three, and he answers for the Bearcats. Josh Delaney with his second three of the second half, and he now has 8. 6.5 to play, still a 4-point game. Ali will shoot the three, bullseye again. Suddenly, after we told you they were 10 of 36, we've got 3 straight three-pointers. Guess all you had to do is talk bad about it.
Yeah, I guess they heard you, Tom.
45-38, Islanders by 7. Little 2-3 matchup zone. Nope. Back to man-to-man as Francis flashes out. Poked away from behind by Hamid Ali. Goes out of bounds. See if we can see what happens here. Here's Ali from behind.
It's hard to get a good angle there.
Yeah, I don't know that anybody else touched it.
They're saying shot clock violation.
Oh, there you go.
Down to 0, so we'll see.
And there it is.
They are.
All right, definitely not a turnover, but the shot clock did expire. So good job by the officials getting together, huddling, getting the call right.
As well as Hamid Ali, who was indicating to the officials that it was at 0. There was a shot clock violation, so.
When you're the senior captain,
that's
your job.
Yep.
Here's Curry in the lane. Goes strong, put back is good.
Rashawn Thomas
now at 9. And you see the Islanders slapping the floor. It's called a kill here for A&M Corpus Christi. That's looking for 3 straight non-scoring possessions by the opposing team. And Dakari Anderson says, no kill here. I'm knocking down the 3 ball, and I've got 18.
Wow, whale of a game.
Dakari Henderson, the junior guard, 6'2", out of Dawson High School in Pearland, Texas. We get a timeout call by Jason Hooten and the Texas A&M Bearcats with 5:17 to go and a 6-point lead for A&M Corpus Christi. Boy, was that a big answer by Henderson.
It sure was.
You look like the Islanders were about to wrest control of this game and maybe get a double-digit lead. And Henderson, who has 18 points in the ballgame, says nothing doing, my friends. 3 of 6 from long range, 6 of 11 shooting on the night for his 18-point total. Well, they haven't updated the score sheet here. They got him at 3 of 6, so make him 4 of 7 with that one, because that's his 4th one of the ballgame.
Yeah, Henderson averaging 13 points on the season for the 6'2 junior out of Pearland.
He's their second leading scorer, right behind Aramis Myauskas. And the Islanders done a great job on Myauskas
they
tonight,
have.
Holding him to just 4 points in the game.
Yeah, Miosk is averaging 14 points on the season, so a lockdown job on Miosk.
Jelani Curry in the corner. We get a holding foul. No, we get a moving screen. And it's going to be on Rashawn Thomas.
Also on the Islanders, number 25, Rashawn Thomas.
And that'll be his fourth. So both Thomas and Duvier have four, and Duvier is going to come in. Thomas will come out with 5:04 to go.
I think that's a great move by Coach Wilson.
Yep.
You've got Rashawn on the bench with four. You've got Duvier back on the floor with four. So got a little security blanket on the bench.
You got Dale Francis out there who gives you some size, but he's not the interior player the other two are.
No, but hopefully.
Uh-oh, Henderson again. This time off the iron, no good off the top of the backboard. Rebound fought for, out of bounds. Last touch, they say, by A&M Corpus Christi. It hit the top of the backboard, but did not hit the clock, so it stayed. That means
correct.
It's still alive.
It can actually roll across the top as long as it doesn't hit anything behind the backboard.
Exactly. So here is Josh Delaney, who's been a big weapon for the Bearcats in the second half with 8 points. Keeping them close. They trail by six, 4.5 to go. Jamal Williams has to give it up to Delaney. Delaney gets around Duvier, but gets cut off in the corner.
Good.
Shot clock is down to five. Delaney with a step back jumper, no good. Rebound fought for, Almanza off the glass, got the roll, Albert Almanza. What a tough rebound that was to put back.
It was, and Duvier was standing there and couldn't do anything with four fouls on the board. Had to let him have it.
Approaching 4 minutes to play, 4 points is the lead for the Islanders with the ball. Ali from 17, won't go, Almanza clears the glass. For the Bearcats, who can pull even closer here. Majauskas in the lane, back out for Delaney's three. Got it!
It's another one.
Delaney with three threes as part of his 11 points, and we're back to a one-point game. This was 37-27. Now it's 47-46. Curry with a drive to the basket, the ball poked out of his hands by Williams on the drive. Bring us to an official's timeout. 3 minutes, 25 seconds to go from the American Bank Center in Corpus Christi. Don't you go anywhere. We got a dandy in our Southland Conference Game of the Week. 1 point lead for A&M Corpus Christi. Forty-7-46, Texas A&M Corpus Christi clinging to a one-point lead. They led it by as many as 10 here in the second half, but sparked by Dakari Henderson and Josh Delaney, the Bearcats have made a run to claw back to within one. Jelani Curry with a 1-1, misses the front end. Bearcats with a rebound and a chance to go in front. Here's Jamal Williams. Three from the corner. No good by Almanza. Rebound. Fought for and a foul. Henderson had the rebound. And he's going to get a chance to shoot. Fouls on Brandon Pye.
The second personal foul. Sixth team foul.
They say that Henderson was in the act of shooting and he's going to have a chance to put his team in front. But first he's got to do something nobody else has done for the Bearcats tonight. Make a free throw. And he did.
Couldn't come at a better time.
19 now.
One of seven times.
Dakari Henderson ties the game.
One of seven from the free throw line.
And in Corpus Christi, only 2 of 4, so they're not exactly lighting it up. Henderson for the lead. Got it. 20 points for Dakari Henderson. And the Bearcats have come from 10 down to take a 1-point lead. 3 minutes to play. Hamid Ali swings it out to Bryce Duvier. Duvier driving on Almanza, righty off the glass, no good, rebound. Duvier fights for it, taken away on the floor by Delaney. Delaney got it to Majauskas, and here come the Bearcats. Down to 2:35 left. Ali against Williams. Got a screen and got loose, so picked up on the switch by Thomas for Majauskas. Back to Williams. Back out to Majauskas. Three to shoot. Two to shoot. They're not going to get away in time. Shot clock violation, I believe. Yes.
Yes, Majauskas was not aware of the shot clock. He had the ball with 3 seconds remaining. We'll see it right there.
And Henderson tried to get it away in time, but he didn't. Great defensive set when it was needed most by the Islanders. Down to 2:10 left. We're going to get a foul on Almanza, getting tied up with Duvier.
Also
for Almanza, that's his second.
Albert Almanza, the second personal foul.
Bryce Duvier to the free throw line for the first time tonight.
Islanders, number 23, Bryce Duvier.
Duvier is 76% on the season. First trip to the line tonight. First one on the way and good. Ties the game at 48. Ihab Amin will come in. It's going to get Brandon Pye. .208 left. Duvier can put the Islanders back in front. Does. First player for A&M Corpus Christi in double figures. They've got a very balanced attack here tonight. 49-48, Islanders by one, 2 minutes to play. Jamal Williams hounded by Ihab Amin. Delaney again for three, in and out, no good. Rebound tipped by Almanza, taken away.
Big
by
rebound.
Ihab Amin.
Big rebound for the Islanders.
Deflected pass, picked up on the carom by Jelani Curry.
Got to take care of the ball and you got to run the shot clock down.
Here's Amin. Looks inside for Thomas. Double team. Tries to find room, lost the ball. Offensive foul and Thomas is going to be gone.
And that's the second game in a row that Thomas has fouled out, Tom.
Inside of 2 minutes to play.
Correct.
So Rashawn Thomas will leave the ball game with 9 points. Watch here. Got stripped. Going for the ball. They say Delaney had it. He tried to rip it out of there. They're going to bring Emmanuel Toney in. Go a little bit smaller. On the defensive side, 1:22 left. Sam Houston State trails by one, has the ball. Williams flips it off for Henderson. For Majauskas, shot clock at 15. Majauskas holds out high. Finds Henderson. 17 footer off balance, no good, rebound. Ihab Amin with another one.
Another big defensive rebound for the Islanders.
down to 47 seconds to go. 19 on the shot clock.
You've got to play it out without fouling if you're Sam Houston.
Almanza is on Ali. Ali trying to drive. Down low for Curry. He got it to go. Curry's first basket of the game. 27 seconds to go.
One possession game.
Timeout, Jason Hooten. Well, if you believe in deja vu, we've almost got it here. Last year, the final score, 51-49. Right now, it's 51-48 with 23.5 to go. Jelani Curry with a huge basket for the Islanders. So now, you're Jason Hooten. I think you're looking for one of two guys, Neil. You're looking for Dakari Henderson, or you're looking for Josh Delaney.
I agree. Delaney's been hot as of late here in the second half with 3 3-pointers.
He's 3 of 5, Henderson 4 and 8, and from behind the arc tonight.
Yeah, I think you've got to do it soon enough, probably within the first 10 seconds, because if you're not able to make it, you've got to foul. And hope that hope that the Islanders will miss it. Either team has been exceptional from the line tonight, so
not at all.
It kind of plays into your favor.
Free throw shooting has been a severe bugaboo for both of these clubs. Two of eight for Sam Houston State. 4 of 6 for the Islanders.
If you're the Islanders, you need to crash the boards. They've done a great job the last two possessions, crashing the defensive boards and coming away with them.
Rebounds 39 for Sam Houston State, 36 for Corpus Christi. 23 and a half seconds to go. Islanders will be on defense. The Bearcats need a basket, preferably a long-range one, unless they get somebody open quick to the basket. They have to throw it back in to Williams in the backcourt. Leaves for Delaney. Delaney for Henderson. Down to 15. Henderson hounded by Tony. Gave it to Williams. Now to Majewski, stripped away. Here's Amin to the basket. Laid it up. No. Rebound, Majewski. And Majewski was out of bounds.
That's what they're saying.
Yep.
Wow, big break for the Islanders.
I couldn't tell, bodies were in front of me. Let's watch it here. Stripped by Amin. Left it short. Oh, yep, there you saw. Yeah. When Majewski's got the dribble, he dribbled it out of bounds.
Good call.
3.5 seconds to go. And the Islanders get the inbound.
Got to foul immediately if you're Sam Houston.
Steal by Delaney. Clock down to 1. Three-quarter court shot.
Wow.
No good. Oh, man, what a finish. Oh, baby. Well, we told you, when these teams get together, it's a war. Let's watch it again. Here's Delaney. Desperation from 60 feet. Just off target.
Well, I guess you don't have to foul when you've got Delaney. Nice job defensively. Had a shot, but didn't go.
Outstanding ball game tonight here in our Southland Conference Game of the Week, as Texas A&M Corpus Christi snaps a two-game losing streak, improves to 17-5 on the season, 8-2 in the Southland Conference. With this 51-48 victory over Sam Houston State, the Bearcats back at 500 at 12-12. They are now 7-4 in conference play. Jeff Power trying to work his way on to get our Islander player of the game. And Jeff is standing by with Bryce Dubier, who had 10 points in the ball game. Jeff?
Yeah, Bryce Dubier, 10 points, but you played with 4 fouls pretty late in the game. Just talk about how big of a win this is, beating Sam Houston State. This is only the second time in the last 9 games.
Yeah, they've kind of had our number, especially in the tournament, different things like that. So this is a big win. We had a great crowd here today, so yeah, give the fans what they want. So it was a big time win for us.
And a homecoming on top of that. I mean, big crowd, as you mentioned, but also to win a nail biter just like last year. It was almost like deja vu.
No, it has been. I mean, we've lost the last couple games now. It's all been close games. So it was good to finally close one out and get one at home.
Final thoughts as you go down the stretch run here in the Southland Conference. Can the Islanders somehow catch SFA and at least get a bye in that top 4?
I definitely think so. I mean, we got them one more time on the schedule. They got to play a couple other tough teams in the conference, and we'll see what happens.
Cool. Bryce Duvier, 10 points. Back to you, Tom.
All right, thanks very much, Jeff. 10 points and 8 rebounds for Duvier. He was the only player for Texas A&M Corpus Christi in double figures. 9 for Rashawn Thomas, 8 for Joe Kilgore in the first half, 7 for Ehab Amin, who really came up with some big defensive plays late in the going for Texas A&M Corpus Christi. For Sam Houston State, 20 points for Dakari Henderson, 11 off the bench, all in the second half for Josh Delaney. Shooting in the ball game, not good for either team, 35.8 for Sam Houston State. They were 19 of 53, 8 of 24 from long range. There are your stats on the board. Texas A&M Corpus Christi, 21 of 66 and 5 of 19 from long range. Free throws a bugaboo, 2 of 8 for Sam Houston State, 4 of 6 for Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Rebounds almost even, 37 to 39 in favor of Sam Houston State. Turnovers, 21 turnovers for Sam Houston State. The Islanders converted those into 21 points. Meanwhile, 15 turnovers for A&M Corpus Christi created 8 points for Sam Houston State. Bench points 20 to 15 in favor of the Islanders. Neil, what a war we saw tonight here in our Southland Conference Game of the Week.
Another Donnybrook. It seems like both, anytime these two teams lace it up, it's going to be a great game. And I think the two defensive stops by the Islanders went under a minute with a difference in this contest.
Well, no time for the winning Islanders of Texas A&M Corpus Christi to rest. They got to go right back at it here on Monday as they welcome in the Houston Baptist Huskies, who lost a tough one at home tonight to Stephen F. Austin by a score of 72 to 66. So they dropped to 8-2. So now those two teams are tied behind SFA in the Southland Conference standings.
Yeah, you're trying to get into the top four, and more importantly, if you can get in the top two, it's really important because then you get two byes. Top four, you get one. Top two, you get two, Tom.
Meanwhile, for the Sam Houston State Bearcats, they'll have time to recover. They get a little extra time off, and the head coach Jason Newton said they've had a tough stretch here. He's actually going to tell his kids to stay home tomorrow. Don't think about basketball. Watch the Super Bowl, have a good time, and then come back to practice hard on Monday. The Bearcats still with a chance of getting that upper echelon and getting one of those byes. Remember, the third and four seeds receive one bye in the postseason tournament, and Katie, the one and two seeds will receive two byes in the postseason tournament. So that'll do it tonight from the American Bank Center here in Corpus Christi, Texas, where we saw Dandy as the Islanders of Texas A&M Corpus Christi before a big season high crowd of 3,713 on homecoming night score a 51-48 win over the Sam Houston State Bearcats. For Jeff Power and Neil Raphael and our entire crew, Tom Franklin saying so long from Corpus Christi.
I'm Christy Felice, and I am the Director of Brand Engagement for the Houston Astros. Texas A&M University of Corpus Christi has absolutely helped get me to where I am today, and it is a small campus with large opportunities. You should definitely choose Texas A&M University Corpus Christi.
Named a top Texas university for return on investment, Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Discover your island. Visit us for Island Day at islandday.tamucc.edu.